The Muppet Show. The Muppet Show is a comedy television series created by Jim Henson and featuring the Muppets. After two pilot episodes produced in 1974 and 1975 failed to get the attention of network executives in the United States, Lew Grade approached Henson to produce the program in the United Kingdom for ITV. Five series of 120 episodes were broadcast on ITV and other ITV franchises in the United Kingdom from 1976 to 1981. The series was filmed at Elstree Studios, England. The Muppet Show is presented as a variety show, featuring recurring sketches and musical numbers intertwined with plot lines taking place behind the show. Kermit the Frog is portrayed as a showrunner who tries to maintain control of the overwhelming antics of the other Muppet characters, as well as appease the guest stars. The series is known for its uniquely designed characters, vaudevillian wit, physical slapstick, sometimes absurdist humor, and its slate of parodies. Each episode also features a different guest star. As the series' popularity rose, many celebrities were eager to perform with the Muppets in television and in film. The cast of performers over the course of the series consisted of Henson, Frank Oz, Jerry Nelson, Richard Hunt, Dave Goles, Steve Whitmire, Fran Brill, Aaron Oskar, Louise Gold, Catherine Mullen, Karen Prell, Brian Mule, Bob Payne, and John Lovelady. Many of the performers also worked on Sesame Street, whose characters made sporadic appearances on The Muppet Show. Jerry Jell and Jack Burns were two of the head writers. The music was performed by Jack Parnell and his orchestra. Since 1969, Sesame Street had given Jim Henson's Muppet creations exposure, however, Henson began to perceive that he was pigeonholed as a children's entertainer. He sought to create a program that could be enjoyed by young and old. Two specials were produced and aired on ABC that are considered pilots for The Muppet Show. Neither led to the sale of a primetime network series. However, the primetime access rule had just been enacted, which took the 7:30 to 8 p.m. ET slot from the networks and turned it over to their affiliates. CBS suggested it would be interested in Henson's proposal as a syndicated series it could purchase for its owned and operated stations, to run one night a week in that time slot. According to the original pitch reel, Rowan and Martin's Laugh-In co-creator George Schlatter was originally going to be involved. Lew Grade, head of the British commercial station ATV and accustomed to the idea of puppet television considering he underwrote the various 1960s Super Mario Nation series produced by Jerry Anderson such as Thunderbirds, offered a deal to Henson that would see his show produced at the ATV studios in Elstree, England. ATV, as part of the ITV network, would broadcast the show to other ITV stations in the United Kingdom, and its distribution arm, ITC Entertainment, would sell the show in the United States and around the world. Henson put aside his misgivings about syndication and accepted. Since its launch in 2005, the British digital channel Puppet TV, dedicated to broadcasting puppeteering programs, has rebroadcast The Muppet Show. It has also dedicated months to broadcasting the show back-to-back. In 2006 it dedicated the summer to broadcasting the entire series episode by episode from 6:00 a.m. to 10:30 a.m., calling it an absolute Muppet summer. It broadcast all Muppet films on the 31st October and November 1, 2009 in the Muppet Flick Fest and then in 2011, following the announcement of the Muppet reboot film, rebroadcast all episodes of both The Muppet Show and Muppets Tonight from 10 March to 10th of April in Complete Muppets. In 2014, Kermit, Fozzie and Sweetums visited the Puppet TV studios in Sussex for the When the Muppets Visited Puppet. Following Steve Whitmire's firing as Kermit's puppeteer, the channel dedicated a month to the puppeteer's best performances in Kermit and Steve: A Match Made in Heaven in February 2017. The Muppet Show theme is the show's theme song. It is the opening and closing theme for every episode of The Muppet Show and was performed by the Muppets in a scene of the Muppets. At the end of the song, Gonzo the Great appeared on stage to play the final note, with various comical results. For the first series, he struck the O in the show's logo as a gong. In all other series, he appeared within the O to play a trumpet. Each episode ended with an extended instrumental performance of the Muppet Show theme by the Muppet Orchestra before Statler and Waldorf gave the last laugh of the night. Some last laugh sequences featured other Muppets on the balcony. For example, in one episode, the Muppets of Sesame Street appeared behind the duo who told them, "How should we know how to get to Sesame Street? We don't even know how to get out of this stupid theater box." Every series, the TV version of the song was presented with reworked lyrics. While the opening sequence evolved visually over the course of the show's five series, the musical composition remained essentially the same. Throughout the years, the song has become a staple of the franchise. The Muppet Theater is the setting for The Muppet Show, a grand old vaudeville house that has seen better days. In episode 106, Kermit identifies the name of the theater as the Benny Vandergast Memorial Theater, although other episodes merely identify it as the Muppet Theater. It's also identified as merely Muppet Theater, and it's a very merry Muppet Christmas movie. It is then that the theater becomes registered as a historical landmark, and it cannot be shut down. According to the Phantom of the Muppet Theater, the theater was built by a stage actor named John Stone in 1802. At some point, a production of Hamlet ran in the theater, with Stone playing the title role. An alternate exterior is also shown in the book. Locations seen in the Muppet Theater include backstage right, the dressing rooms, the attic, the canteen, the prop room, the stage, Statler and Waldorf's box, the auditorium, reception, the recording studio, the stage door lobby, and the back alley. Some of these sets were later reused as the Happiness Hotel in The Great Muppet Caper. A replica of the theater serves as the setting for the Muppet Vision 3D attraction at Disney's Hollywood Studios and Disney California Adventure. Scooter's uncle J.P. Grossa owns the theater, and rents it to the Muppets, as Scooter is only too happy to remind Kermit. In a deleted scene from It's a Very Merry Muppet Christmas Movie, Kermit reveals that J.P. has died and left the theater to the Muppets in his will. This would have taken place sometime after 1996, as J.P. can be seen in episode 107 of Muppets Tonight, the 1990s reworking of The Muppet Show. The Muppet Theater is shown to be in New York City as Rachel Bitterman plots to tear down the Muppet Theater and build a club. She is thwarted when Pepe the King Prawn manages to get the Muppet Theater to be made into a national landmark. In the film The Muppets, a badly deteriorated version of the Muppet Theater is located next to Muppet Studios in Los Angeles. The Muppets reunite in hopes of raising enough money to buy the theater from oil magnate Tex Richman before he can demolish it and start drilling for oil once site. Many of the characters who appeared on The Muppet Show have appeared in previous and subsequent Muppets productions. No guest star ever appeared twice on The Muppet Show, although John Denver appeared both on the show and in two specials, while Dudley Moore reappeared in the special, The Muppets Go to the Movies. Additionally, several guest stars from the series had cameos in one of the first three Muppet theatrical films. Originally, the producers had to call in their personnel contacts to appeal to them to appear, especially considering that doing so meant an overseas trip to Britain to do so. However, the situation changed when the renowned ballet dancer Rudolf Nureyev offered to appear. His performance on this unusual TV program produced so much favorable publicity that the series became one of the most sought after for various celebrities to appear in. Many episodes featured actors, such as Steve Martin, Don Knotts, Harvey Korman, and Dom DeLuisa. Some featured veteran performers like Ethel Merman and Rita Moreno. Some featured well-known pop singers, including Elton John, Diana Ross, Linda Ronstadt, and Leo Sayer. Sayer's show used his hit The Show Must Go On. He changed the lyrics in the second verse slightly, from "I wish I could tear down the walls of this theater" to "I wish I could tear down the walls of this Muppet theater." The last episode, in 1981, featured then-James Bond actor Roger Moore. Mark Hamill appeared in one episode as both himself and Luke Skywalker, his role in the Star Wars film series. One episode featured staff writer Chris Langham, guest starring due to Richard Pryor being unable to make the taping of the episode at the last minute. An early tradition was to present the guest star with a Muppet likeness of themselves as a parting gift at the end of the show, but this only lasted for the first two episodes produced, featuring Connie Stevens and Juliet Prowse. The high cost and effort of creating these unique Muppets, scheduling conflicts, and potential legal issues contributed to the decline of this practice, although Muppet caricatures and parodies would continue to appear. The first episode opens on a character called Wally and develops as he types the script on his typewriter. In the second pilot, a new character called Nigel acts as the backstage boss. Statler and Waldorf grumble from a living room while watching the show on television. In both pilot episodes, Kermit the Frog only plays a supporting role. Kermit the Frog becomes the host for the show from the start of the first series, while former host Nigel gets a part as the orchestra leader. Statler and Waldorf now watch the show from a balcony. Other characters from the pilots, including Dr. Teeth and the Electric Mayhem, Sam Eagle, the Swedish Chef, George the Janitor, Mildred Huckstetter, Crazy Harry, Brewster, Nigel the Conductor, and Droop continue to make appearances. Characters from previous Jim Henson productions also make appearances, including Ralph the Dog, Sweetums and Robin the Frog, Miss Piggy, Gonzo the Great, and Thog. New characters include Fozzie Bear, the Muppet Newsman, Scooter, Dr. Bunsen Honeydew, Wardrobe Lady Hilda, Uncle Deadly, Marvin Suggs and his Muppaphones, Trumpet Girl, and the singing duet of Wayne and Wanda. Recurring sketches include Veterinarian's Hospital, At the Dance, Talking Houses, Panel Discussions, Fozzie's Monologue, Talk Spot, Muppet Labs and Gonzo's Act. Several changes were made for the second series. Each week, Scooter would now greet the guest star in his or her dressing room before the opening theme song by announcing the time until curtain call. The opening theme sequence was replaced with one involving the cast in arches. Sketches such as At the Dance, Talk Spot, Panel Discussions, Talking Houses, and Fozzie's Monologue either made fewer appearances or were dropped altogether. Several characters were rebuilt, with noticeable changes in Miss Piggy, Fozzie Bear, and Gonzo the Great. Characters like George the Janitor, Hilda, Mildred, and Wayne and Wanda were dropped from the series. Robin is identified as Kermit's nephew. New sketches include Pigs in Space and an editorial by Sam the Eagle. New characters include Bunsen Honeydew's assistant Beaker, Link Hogthrob, Dr. Julius Strangebork, Doglian, and Annie Sue. Muppet performers Aaron Oskar and John Lovelady departed from The Muppet Show after the first series. In early episodes of the second series, female puppeteers were auditioned to replace Oskar. Louise Gold was eventually hired as Oskar's replacement. Jack Burns quit his role as writer after the first series. All of the characters and sketches from the previous series remained. New characters included dim-witted stagehand Beauregard, boomerang fish thrower Lou Zealand, cafeteria lady Gladys, Bobby Benson, and his baby band, and sports commenter Louis Kazager. New segments included Muppet Sports and Baron Patrol. Two new puppeteers, Steve Whitmire and Catherine Mullen, joined the troupe of Muppeteers during this series. Also, in early episodes of the third series, Peter Friedman was auditioned to replace John Lovelady as a sixth male Muppet performer. Steve Whitmire was eventually hired, replacing Lovelady officially as a sixth male performer. Most of the characters and sketches from the previous series remained. Canteen worker Gladys, however, was replaced by a new character, Winnie. Rizzo the Rat also made his earliest appearances. Rizzo made his first appearance as Super Rat in the episode which featured Christopher Reeve as its guest star. The cold open featuring Scooter visiting the guest star's dressing room was replaced by a new opening in which Pops, the doorman, would greet each guest as they entered the theater. New characters included Pops, Lips, and Gaffer the Cat. Two new puppeteers, Brian Mule and Karen Prell, joined the troupe of Muppeteers during this series, and also Betsy Bados was auditioned to perform in 8 episodes during this season. The Muppet Show program was nominated for 9 BAFTA Awards during its run, winning 3. It was nominated for 21 Primetime Emmy Awards, winning 4, including the 1978 Award for Outstanding Comedy Variety or Music Series. It was presented with a Peabody Award in 1978. Also in 1978, the show received the Television Award of Merit by the Mary Washington Colonial Chapter of the National Society of the Daughters of the American Revolution. In 1985, Playhouse Video released a collection of video compilations under the Jim Henson's Muppet Video banner. 10 videos were released, featuring original linking material in addition to clips from the show. Videos included. In 1993, Jim Henson Video released 2 compilations under the It's the Muppets banner, Meet the Muppets and More Muppets, Please. Later, 3 volumes of The Very Best of The Muppet Show were released on VHS and DVD in the UK. Unlike the Playhouse Video releases, It's the Muppets and The Very Best of The Muppet Show did not include any original footage or guest star clips, but all compilation collections did include material cut from the original US broadcasts. In 1994, Jim Henson Video released The Muppet Show, Monster Laughs with Vincent Price, featuring the episodes with Vincent Price and Alice Cooper. Both episodes were edited. In addition to replacing the first series opening and the ending logos with suit, the Vincent Price episode was edited to remove the songs I'm Looking Through You and You've Got a Friend, as well as a sketch with the Talking Houses, while the Alice Cooper episode removed Robin's performance of Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Time Life and Jim Henson Home Entertainment began marketing best of volumes of The Muppet Show for mail order in 2001, with 6 initial volumes with 3 episodes on each VHS and DVD. Unique to each episode was an introduction by Jim Henson's son, Brian. 9 more volumes were added for 2002, The Muppets' 25th anniversary. The collection was available for retail in 2002 via Sony Pictures Home Entertainment and Jim Henson Home Entertainment, by which time Life had released its 10th volume. Buena Vista Home Entertainment released the first series on DVD in Region 1 on August 9, 2005. The rights to the episodes and characters used in The Muppet Show, and subsequent film outings, were bought in February 2004 by the Walt Disney Company. Several songs were cut from the Series 1 DVD release due to music licensing issues. There have also been some cuts in the intro sequence, and backstage scenes leading up to these songs. However, episodes that used Disney music remained unaltered. The only uncut release of Season 1 on DVD so far is the German DVD release by Disney's Buena Vista Home Entertainment division from 2010. However, the intro and end credit sequences on this release are in German. The following Season 4 and Season 5 episodes have never been released for home video: Linda Lavin, Shields, and Yarnell, Crystal Gale, Arlo Guthrie, Victor Berga, Phyllis George, Diane Cannon, Christopher Reeve, Dizzy Gillespie, and Murray, Jonathan Winters, Andy Williams, Doug Henning, Carol Channing, Alan Arkin, Shirley Bassey, Joan Baez, Glenda Jackson, Loretta Sweet, Hal Linden, Jean-Pierre Rumpal, Chris Langham, Melissa Manchester, Gladys Knight, Wally Bogue, and Buddy Rich. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.